with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about Invisalign's Align Technologies Palatal Expander. And I've been telling you for years that they, well, I've been telling you for a decade they should do it. I've been telling you for 5 years since I initially, initially saw the patent proposal that they were going to do it. And now they must be about to release this thing because I'm getting a flurry of investors and other people contacting me. When's it coming out? Have you seen it? Have you touched it? Do you know how it works? So started digging. You know, obviously I'd read the patent proposal. It made sense. It's not rocket science. There's nothing special about. So let me clarify to those people who are not orthodontists. Okay. We're going to talk about this on three different levels. What is a palatal expander? You need to look through all my YouTube videos. I have an entire course on this. But in a nutshell, it works differently than aligner, which is tipping, okay? Tipping teeth to make an arch wider so that in kids you can get the airway and the palatal remodeling benefits and all the benefits that come with actually stretching the bones and widening the bones, not just tipping the teeth, okay? So it's better. Can't do this very easily in adults without surgery. Some form of surgery, be it mini implants, jaw surgery, stuff like that, post-pubertal. So in girls, you can only do this maybe up to 8 to 13, 8 to 14, you know, and actually get the skeletal benefits. In boys, definitely a lot older. A lot of it depends on the skeletal age. If you want to know more about the skeletal age or how a palatal expander works, fixed or removable, take my phase one course, or all the videos are available in my phase one YouTube channel, my Straight Smile Solutions YouTube channel, but the phase one playlist. Okay. So I'm assuming now that if you're listening to this video specifically about Align Technology or Invisalign's palatal expander, the Align expander, I don't know what they're going to call it, that you know what a palatal expander is. You know the difference between aligners expanding and a palatal expander. You know who can get it, how you do it, how it works, everything like that, the whole anatomy of it. Okay. Now, first of all, let me give you a disclaimer. I kleptoed this from online. It was a presentation from 2018 that it is the property of Align Technology. It is not my property. I have not touched, felt, or seen one of these suckers, okay? I do not have permission to share this. So as always, Align Technology, this video will only benefit you. So by creating awareness, because the amount of interest that suddenly came today, something must be going down because something's going down because everyone's reaching out to me about Align's palatal expander suddenly out of thin air. So there's really almost nothing if you search Google on it. I mean, this is the only thing I could find besides the patent proposal. So they've been real careful. So this must have leaked itself. So I'm just sharing what was already leaked. Align Technology, as always, you and we have a symbiotic relationship in that if you tell me to take something down, I will take it down. So don't threaten me. Don't send me letters. Don't send me certified letters. Don't send your minions out to threaten me or up things that you've done in the past. You know what you've done. And y'all, I'm not sponsored by Align. I don't get a cent from them or anything like that. It's just a good product. So, and if you see from my videos, you know, for a harder case, it is the superior product, hands down. I mean, and I get no benefit for saying that. It's just way easier to work with and you get predictable outcomes. But anyways, yeah, this is a no-brainer. I mean, obviously, I've been doing palatal expanders, be it fixed or removable, with Invisalign for 20 years. I mean, you just do that first and order from any OrthoLab, lab fee about $100, $150. And then when the expander is complete and retained, you go ahead and pop it off and you do the Invisalign. Just a two-step process, takes a few more months, not a big deal, right? Extra $150. You're gonna get a way better outcome than if you just tip teeth, and you're gonna get all the airway benefits and facial remodeling benefits that come with it. So no brainer. But hey, cool, if I'm gonna do Invisalign anyways, why do I want to pay that extra $150, right? I might as well have it bundled in. So this is what the sucker is going to look like. And to me, I'm sorry. I mean, it is using CAD/CAM technology. So I mean, that's cool. But to me, this looks so janky. I'm sorry, Invisalign. I honestly thought it was going to be an aligner with a jack screw in it so that we were removing teeth at the same time that we were expanding. But it's not. It's this, which is basically a 3D printed, why 3D printed little snap-on. I'm sorry, you guys. I mean, I told you I was going to benefit you. I'm not saying it's not going to work. It's just so janky. That's just the word I showed my daughter, and she's had an expansion. She goes, janky. Come on, Invisalign. You can do better than that. It's ugly. It's ugly. And I, I really feel like this would be really, really good for an open bite patient. Okay, I'm on board for an open bite patient. This makes 100% sense to me. But for a deep bite patient, pass. I'm going to go ahead and use my regular expander with the fixed bite plate for sure. Or I'm going to use a Schwartz and put an anterior bite plate on it. This would be terrible. If this is the only option, and I don't know, this is the only thing I saw. No, I'm not using it in a deep bite patient. Definitely not. But an open bite patient, long face, steep mandibular plane angle, sure. Especially if it's free, I'll save the $150, but we're not aligning at the same time. So that's the only bump, you know, bummer part, but it sounds like it's rapid expansion. You're going to be a little sore. Exchange daily, it says. So you're going to get, it's going to get wider, 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 wider. So if it's rapid expansion at 0.25 millimeters per day, that's like one jack screw. That's rapid. That's basically telling me you're going to get a big old gap in the front. So, I mean, on one hand, it's good because it looks like you're going to, this is normal. I mean, you're going to finish your expansion quicker than maybe I do normally in slow expansion, which takes 3 to 4 months and then you retain it. But it looks like it's going to be rapid. I don't know. I don't see the compliance on this being great. It's really going to affect their speech. I mean, it'll definitely work. So we'll have to see if they, I mean, maybe this is just a prototype. Maybe from, this is from 5 years ago. Maybe it's snazzier than what I'm looking at. And maybe there are modifications for deep bites, but I don't think that there could be because you're covering the back teeth. So they're using this for retention, unless there's a way that they can do it just on the front teeth and leave the back teeth. I mean, I don't see why they couldn't hollow, you know, use a retention on the front teeth and use clasps. I don't know, but I guess that's not part of their 3D printing technology. But anyways, sorry, long, long thing. So again, Invisalign, if you don't like what I posted, you can nicely contact me. And it has to be someone pretty high up, not just a random, you know, territory manager. You guys know who, I know who works there. Someone like C-suite level needs to contact me nicely via email, okay? Not social media. I don't need a letter coming in the mail either. I hate those when they come from you guys. They stress me out. So I'm just creating awareness because the amount of questions that suddenly showed up today, Valentine's Day, is massive. So something must be going down. That's all I'm saying. All right. Thanks so much.